All right, welcome to a special roundtable edition. We like to call this old air gun. So here's how it works. The Godfather, Tom Gaylord, is going to tell us about some old air guns that he has that basically me and Rick and Jim here are going to listen and learn a bit, a little something from the master. So what are we? I'm seeing toys. These look like toys to me. What am I looking at, Tom?
Well, they should look like toys because they were made by Whammo, the hula hoop people.
Really?
Yes, sir. They
Whammo
were.
Used to make guns.
Yes, Whammo made firearms and BB guns, and I've got three of those BB guns here today.
Okay.
Wow. This
I mean,
is
look
the,
at this pack. That's I just got to look at this packaging. I mean, this is.
You be careful with that.
How old is this?
That's early 60s, and that was my first BB gun.
Really?
Wow. Not that particular one, but one just like it.
Sure.
My mother did not want me to have a BB gun, and so I'm sure she went out and found the absolute slowest, lowest powered gun she could possibly find. The funny thing about this is it's not really an air gun.
Okay.
It uses toy caps, roll caps like we used to have in our six shooters.
Sure. Mm.
And it uses the power of those going off to propel the BB. And if you think that's anemic, I mean, they come out at about 50 feet per second. They just like
yeah, like just shoot your buddy.
Terrible.
Four or 5 foot targets, right?
No,
if that's
a long range shot. But what they did was they capitalized on the World War II. This is a Luger looking thing, and they called it a Kruger so they wouldn't step on anybody's toes.
The old Kruger.
The old Kruger, yes.
All right.
And it also, if you
Kruger
were a clever guy,
so we're
you could make a dart. Now that little dart, that's wicked.
Now that's interesting. There you go. Check this out.
Yeah. That would actually have a chance of sticking into something like a cork board if you shot from about 2-3 feet away.
Sure.
That's something.
So so you could load darts or a BB
BBs,
in it.
Yes.
And they used the caps to propel it.
Yes, sir.
And they obviously didn't work that well, but they worked.
They worked after a fashion. Let me show you how they worked.
Okay.
What you did was you pull that back,
right?
You stick your cap in there,
okay,
and you leave this back. Then you drop your BB in the muzzle. I'm not kidding.
This is where people get that if you turn your pellet guns upside down, the pellet's gonna fall out.
Probably so. They gave you a little metal ramrod. I don't have it, but they did. It was kind of a coat hanger.
Right.
You ram your BB to the bottom, and you pull the trigger. I'm going to do that because there's no cap and there's no BB.
Okay.
All right. That's it.
There you go.
About 5 times out of 10 on the first 5 shots, the cap would go off. Mm-hmm. After that, it wouldn't because it started getting dirty in here. Well, kids are pretty clever, so you put in 2 caps.
Is that a magnum?
That's a magnum.
Then you get maybe 1 out of 5. Then it doesn't work anymore. You put in 4 caps, and now you just aren't getting it at all.
Sure.
Caps, when they go off, they leave a residue that is highly corrosive, much more than black powder. There's only a little bit of metal in this gun, and it's all right here in the breech. Mm-hmm. So within a day, this thing rusted, and the gun was gone. You aren't going to find many of these because, A, they're plastic and cheap-looking,
right.
And, B, they all rusted up. This one's even rusted.
Yeah, I can see that in there.
Yeah.
Wow. So I mean, at this point, is this a collector's item, or is this something that's just more fun for you to have?
It's a collector's item that has very little value.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think I might have paid $30 on eBay for this before eBay stopped allowing anything that looked like a gun.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, there you go. I mean, you know, back in this $298, so we're talking about, you
That's right.
quite a bit of profit there.
That's appreciated.
But they had an idea. They had the idea, maybe the BB at 5.1 grains is too heavy for the cap. So they came out with the improved Kruger 98. Now, this one I do have the ramrod for.
Yes, you do.
This one doesn't shoot BBs. It shoots those wee teeny little balls, which turn out to be number 6 shotgun shots.
Oh, it's buckshot in there.
It's birdshot.
Smaller than buckshot.
Birdshot.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wee teeny. I don't know if this one works or not. I've never fired it. I just keep it because it's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
But I wrote a huge article for Shotgun News on Whammo because I was very interested in this gun. Come to find out that one of the founders of Whammo actually had a patent. And that patent appears on this gun, which is a Western HAIG. This is the gun that all of us kids wanted to buy for $1.98. You put your cap there, you ram your number 12 shot down there, and maybe or maybe not, it goes off.
Wow.
These are highly collectible because every little boy my age remembers seeing them in magazines for $1.98.
Sure.
And I have this one in the box with the literature and the original owner's name on the box.
And again, all these plastic, I mean, sold as toys, essentially.
Really, they were. Yes.
Wow.
Don't you miss the 60s?
Oh, yeah.
I completely missed the 60s. Just so
you know. I literally missed the 60s.
I just wasn't even there.
Not missed. 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 Wow. How cool is that? I mean, this is... And I'm sure there's got to be a lot of guys that remember that from...
You know the danger of this? The danger is...
Yeah, you can shoot your eye out.
Well, yeah, of course, it's a BB gun. But what if you were a smart kid and your father shot black powder guns, or you were smart enough to take 1,000 caps apart one at a time with your father's razor, take that powder and load it into the barrel and set that off with a cap with a BB in front of it, what would happen then?
You sound like you did it.
I'm saying that we've got, that seems a little bit thought out.
I didn't do it.
Tom was quite a little thug back in his early years. He was
now we know we're quite the godfather.
The gangster.
Yeah, exactly. hey, Timmy, go give me some more caps and get the lead out, huh? Need some more black powder.
North American Arms actually made a 22, a 36, and a 45 that worked that way.
Wow.
You use black powder in the gun, and they thought they were black powder guns, but you use caps to ignite the black powder.
It's a primer.
And like,
it's a primer, that's right.
So this is like a little, I mean, that I doubt it works out, but this is a little cap, right?
Yeah.
Just a little, like, that's a toy black powder in there?
Did you remember playing
with
those?
No, it's an explosive powder that goes off with concussion. Black powder goes off with heat and pressure. That would ignite the black powder.
Got it. Okay.
And give you one heck of an explosion.
Sure. I mean, I had cap guns when I was a kid.
Sure.
We had the roll caps. You could spit out the top, or you had the little like the 6 or 8.
Oh, the discs.
Yeah.
Those were really powerful.
Yeah, they were. That's what my little nephews have now, running around.
Yep.
You know, I remember. Did you ever the straight magazines? Where you would put it in? It was just a long thing.
Like very loud.
20 of them in a row. Yeah.
Yes.
So I can only actually. I wonder. Have you seen cap guns recently?
Only on eBay.
They probably don't even make them like they used to. They
probably make them, but not.
Now everything's Nerf. Yeah, everything's Nerf.
Yeah. Right.
Now everything's orange.
This is not Nerf approved.
Well, let me rephrase. We do airsoft now. Is what we do. That's what the kids are playing with.
There you go.
Man, Tom, I tell you, you never cease to amaze me with your knowledge and some of the stuff that you keep and collect. Are you a hoarder? Be honest.
Were there two syllables or one in that word? A little hard of hearing.
I love it. Well, Tom, I appreciate it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this.
Oh, it was great.
Absolutely.
For hanging out.
My pleasure.
What do you think about this? Could you hunt anything with this?
Well, yeah, maybe flies or dragonflies. But
if anybody could get a fly, I feel like it would be you. Criticisms?
None.
It's a perfect toy for kids. At 6 and under.
Yeah, exactly. There we go. Yeah, no.
All right, well, that's it for this roundtable. Again, gentlemen, thank you very much. If you want to check this stuff out, we're going to have links at AmericanAirGunner.com, of course. You can hit all these guys' links and go to their websites and see what they're talking about and what they're doing. So thanks again. Tom, this is... I love this stuff. I can't wait till the next time.